that?
Yeah. Today on CWN, are you going to the volleyball game?
And there's a tennis match today. I'm Michaela.
And I'm Jonathan. And today is Tuesday, August 23rd, 2022.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance and the pledge to the Texas flag.
The Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. The Texas Pledge. Under the Texas flag, I pledge allegiance to thee, Texas, one state under God, one and indivisible.
Attention students, there is a host meeting today after school in room 701. Also, NHS members, there will be a meeting tomorrow. Make sure to attend and bring your summer hours.
FCCLA signups will be coming up September 1st. This year is all about starting the group and getting as much community service as possible.
Emily caught up with Mr. Valperts for an update on band. Let's see what they have in store for us today.
Good morning, Calallen. Today I'm here with Mr. Valperts, our head band director. So, Mr. Valperts, what has the band been doing to prepare for this upcoming season?
Well, we started training on the last week of July, and we started doing two-day rehearsals then. The first week of August, we started learning drill for our new show, which is called Nocturne. Should be very entertaining. First week of July, we started doing three-day rehearsals, starting to learn drill, those kinds of things, and it's been going very positive. The band students have been working very hard.
So what are y'all planning on playing at the pep rally this week? Can you give us like a sneak peek or anything?
Well, we play a lot of traditional music for pep rallies and up in the stands. So we've been working, of course, on the school song. We've been working on the fight song. We won't pick our stand tune until probably the day of, but we've been working a lot of that music, and it should be really exciting.
Well, good luck to the band this season. That's all from us. Now back to the studio.
Attention 9th, 10th, and 11th graders. If you are interested in taking the PSAT test, that will be given Wednesday, October 12th. Please sign up in the counseling office. The deadline to register for this test is Friday, September 9th. Sign up with your payment of $18 cash. Rev track or check, make payable to Calallen High School. If you miss the registration deadline of September 9th, you will not be able to take the test. Juniors who receive free and or reduced lunch may be eligible for a free waiver. For more information on this test, please visit the counseling office.
Ms. Borse's chemistry class conducted a lab over accuracy and precision. Let's take it to Melissa for more.
Hi, I'm Melissa with Calallen TV, and today I'm interviewing Ms. Borse. Ms. Borse, what can you tell us about the experiment you're doing today in class?
So today what we're doing is an accuracy precision lab. It's called the Great CHS Beanbag Toss Challenge, and we are trying to reinforce our notes over accuracy and precision and measurements so they know how accurate or precise they need to be with their measurements. And they are throwing beanbags towards a specific target, and we are having a contest to determine who actually can be the most precise and the most accurate when they're throwing their three beanbags.
Very nice. And how does this relate to what they're doing in class?
Well, measurement is all part of science, so they have to learn how to accurately and precisely measure things throughout the year. So this is giving them a little bit of a reinforcement and actual real-world application of doing those measurements.
Thank you so much, and back to the studio.
The science teachers have really been taking advantage of the new science wing as of recently. Emma caught Ms. Johns also doing a lab recently. Let's take it to them.
Hey, Cats, I'm here with Ms. Johns and Lauren. So, Lauren, how did you feel about the lab today?
I was really excited about this lab, and I thought it was really cool how the copper, like, at the end, it kind of stuck to the aluminum, and yeah.
Perfect. So, Ms. Johns, what was the purpose of this lab?
Well, we're just introducing chemistry this year, and so it's the first time they get to actually do a little chemistry, but they don't have to worry so much about, did I get my mass right and doing all the calculations. It's just a good way to see a chemical reaction take place. And we're learning about different types of measurements. So they're taking temperatures, they are taking what's called qualitative measurements, which are descriptive terms. So, and then just making a choice on whether or not there's physical chemical changes, and then learning how to interpret data, like making guesses as to what they think is happening. And then we can learn later what was actually happening throughout the year, but I think it's just a good first step into chemistry.
All right. Perfect. Thank you. Back to the studio.
The library will be checking out Chromebooks this week via English classes. Juniors will receive theirs today, sophomores tomorrow, and freshmen on Thursday.
Now let's send it to Luke with a rundown on sports right after we play this quick message.
Good morning, good morning. Let me see your ID. You look a little young in this. What is this, from sixth grade?
Yeah.
You can't bring this. You have to bring one from this year.
Come on, man.
Nah, you come to the office with me.
All right.
Everyone is issued a new ID for the school year, but if you lose it, you will have to come to the front office to buy a new ID for $5. I'm with Ms. Mickens, and she's going to tell you what happens when you bring old IDs into school.
Okay, good morning, cats. Just want to let you know, a reminder, I've told you every morning so far, if you can please not show me any expired IDs, make sure they're current, up to date.
Thank you, anchors, and good morning, Wildcats. Coach Spencer was instrumental in getting a new video board for A-Gym, and we also have cross-country information.
Hi, I'm Callie Rosie-Paul, and I'm here with Coach Spencer. Coach Spencer, I heard y'all got a new scoreboard over the summer. Can you tell me how that's going?
Yeah, absolutely. So we got this awesome new video board up there. We can do scoreboard stuff, run advertisements, run videos. Awesome gift given by the Calallen Education Foundation. We're incredibly thankful for. It's going to be great for pep rallies, for games, for any sort of activities. There's a lot of really cool things that we can do with it.
So I heard cross country is doing good. Can you also tell me something about that?
Yeah, so we ran our TM meet on Friday. We had a couple of girls with some personal bests. We're right back at it again this week. We've already got a couple of practices down on Saturday. We'll run in the Moody meet over at Garcia Park and just continue to try and improve on our times.
So Tanner, how did the last meet at TM go?
I thought it went really good. We had three boys placed top 20. Jude Harms placed 13th, I placed 17th, and Fisher placed 20th.
Good luck to cross country this season. That's all from us. Now back to the studio.
Volleyball has a game today here against Calhoun. JV and freshmen at 5 and varsity at 6. Let's check out this hype video. Be sure to wish a player good luck and come and support. Tennis also has a match today against Flower Bluff at Flower Bluff. Good luck, cats. And that's the latest on Calallen Sports. Now back to the anchors.
Now here's Jace with today's weather forecast after this short break.
I tell you, man, the chicken alfredo is better than the chicken nuggets.
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know?
Hey, guys.
They're both good.
What are you talking about?
We're talking about chicken alfredo and chicken nuggets, yo.
I like the chicken alfredo.
Hey, that's a tornado.
Oh, my God.
Come on, Diego.
What's happening?
That's a tornado.
Oh, my God.
Guys, hurry up, get inside, there's a tornado.
Now what do we do? We're in a weight room, there's weights, and there's a tornado outside. What do you think we should do?
We should get these games!
Heck yeah! Ray, shut up. 95, 95, 100, you play my game, the white one.
No!
Good morning, guys. I'm here with Ms. Lyons from the library. So what would we do if we were in a library and a code gray was called?
Well, first of all, we need to know that a code gray is severe weather. So probably we're looking at thunderstorms or a tornado. If a tornado was coming this way, we'd want to get away from the windows. There'd be flying debris, and we want to get as close to an interior concrete wall as possible.
If you cannot get to the FEMA dome, which is a place of safety, the next best thing is to go in a hallway in an interior building. If you are on a second floor, you need to come down to the first floor and stay away from windows as much as possible. You want to be surrounded by brick walls. That's the safest place to be.
Good morning, Wildcats. I'm Jace Hosteter, and let's take a look at today's weather. But first, we're going to thank our sponsor, Sonic, America's Drive-In. So today we're looking at highs of 86 degrees Fahrenheit with a 2% chance of rain, with winds going south-southwest for 5 miles per hour. Going into the rest of today, we're looking at a low 90s into high 80s for the rest of today, with a very low chance of rain overall, and winds going south-southeast at 11 to 13 miles per hour. Going into the rest of today, we have we have high 80s, low 90s with increasing chances of rain over the weekend, with winds going south to southeast at 10 to 12 miles per hour. That's all for me. Now back to the anchors.
Thank you, Jace.
And that's all for your announcements for today. But now it's time for the joke of the day. So, Michaela, how does a man in the moon cut his hair?
I don't know, Jonathan. How?
Eclipse it.
We'd also like to wish a very happy birthday to Mrs. Lamb over there at the middle school. For all you social people out there, make sure you're following us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at Calallen TV for the latest updates. Also, subscribe to us here on YouTube to watch all of our latest videos. And as always, stay classy, Calallen.